What is up, beautiful people? My name is Helen, aka Ordinary Fit Girl. Welcome to another mukbang and welcome to my channel. For today's mukbang, I have got a medley of fruit. I've got pineapple, I've got pawpaw, aka papaya, I've got mangoes, and I've got some cut up bananas, and I've got some lime here as well because I like to squeeze my lime all over my pineapple. I don't know if anybody else does that, but I do that and it is very, very, very delicious. Currently about to break a 19-hour fast. For those of you that watch my channel, thank you. You know that I like to intermittent fast. For those of you that don't watch my channel, that are not subscribed, do your girl a solid and hit that subscribe button. I'm trying to hit 1,000 subscribers by my birthday in April. Okay, so for today's mukbang, I don't really have a story time. I just thought I would chit chat with you guys. Let's do a taste test actually. People often ask me if I eat all the food that I show in the mukbangs. Yes, this is just a starter. And shout out to my friend Mami for suggesting that I do a fruit mukbang because, you know, it gets a little expensive trying to eat deep fried things for the channel. Also, apologies, allergies are on 1,000. Oh, listen. One good thing about living in Accra is fresh fruit. These pineapples are so juicy. And the lime definitely adds, ooh, I promise I'm not crying. And the lime juice adds that extra little sasson, as my friend Mami likes to say. Anyhow, let's jump into it. Also, comment down below what your favorite fruit is. My all-time favorite fruit is actually watermelon, but I couldn't find any today. I don't know when they're in season. I don't know if it matters anymore if things are in season or not, but we move. So, in case you've been living under a rock or have never been on my channel, I currently live in Accra, in Ghana. And let me tell you, it's been quite the journey, okay? It has been quite the journey. The Accra that I knew growing up as a 8, 9, 10, 11, even 13, 14, 15 year old is not the same Accra that I know today, and for like good and bad reasons as well. I initially moved to Accra because I wanted to just change my life. I was getting tired of having all my organs squeezed on the London Underground. I was tired of the not so subtle ceiling that exists in the corporate world. You know what I'm talking about, brown girls. You know, I was tired of feeling stifled, and I wanted to explore different things. I wanted a different life. I wanted to try and see if I could build a little media portfolio somewhere where I thought it would be easier to get opportunities. I mean, in the kind of interim before I came home, I would take little meetings and auditions, even if you will, with different companies and like different media houses. And I felt like it could be promising. I felt like if I pursue this at home, then who knows where we could go. So that is one of the main reasons why I moved. Also, I was tired of doing a long-distance relationship. I was tired of getting my boobs out on FaceTime. You know, we were trying to do it face a la face. You feel me? So those were the main reasons why I decided to relocate. Let's get into this mango. I've got to be honest, sometimes the texture of mango puts me off. Does that make any sense? Like, I either like it really hard or in like juice form. And I know people hate mango juice, but I don't mind a bit of mango juice, you know? I like a bit of mango juice. Anyhow, so I packed up my bags, obviously quit my job in 2018 in November or in October, you know, packed my bags, relocated to the ACC of the RA, ready to start a new life. And within weeks, I would say I had to settle into a new normal. I had to kind of readjust some of the expectations that I had for my professional life, my love life. I feel like in some ways the rug was pulled from underneath my feet, and I had to figure it out really, 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 really quickly. And whilst I love the hustle and bustle of Accra, it reminds me sometimes of London in that everybody is just searching for money. It took a while to like get into the swing of things. Accra is amazing and juicy and lovely when you have a bit of money to spare and you've got money in your pockets. Let me tell you, Accra can be your Las Vegas. Listen, New York where? Miami where? Okay, you can make Accra all those things when you're rolling in the dosh. And for the most part, I had put money away to make sure that I wasn't going hungry and to make sure that I could do some fun things whilst I was here and explore Accra with you and, you know, find myself. You know, I was trying to find myself. I'm still trying to find myself. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna do a three fruit combo. We're gonna do pineapple, and then we're gonna do mango, and then we're gonna do some pawpaw. Wow, not working. We'll do a two fruit combo.
That's just good.
Sometimes just do fresh fruit, okay? Clear out your crusty pores, it helps. You feel me? Anyway, so back to Accra. So yeah, it took me a while to get into the flow of things. It is now 2020. I definitely feel like I'm in the flow. I feel like I'm getting it. I feel like I'm understanding the dynamics and the politics of it all. But one thing I would say is, before you come to Accra, unless you know that you're getting a steady stream of money, definitely save, 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 and then save some more. I would say also making friends is imperative for finding your way. It's good if you are a returnee like me and you have classmates from whenever you were in school. That always helps. Also, obviously, just maintaining healthy friendships throughout the years if you are a visitor. Is that making any sense? Just, you know, it helps. You need people. Accra, Ghana, it's very community-based. And also when you're looking for work and opportunities, sadly, it really is who you know. So that's one thing I would also suggest that you do before you take the plunge, is if you have healthy relationships with people, maintain them. Or whilst you're here, find ways of making good, strong, positive connections with people who won't scam you for 80 CDs for petrol. Also, be prepared for a new normal. The old life, wherever you were old lifing, is done. Accra, Ghana has its own rules, and you will quickly learn to fall in line. I'm talking about things like driving. It took me such a long time to get the courage to get back behind the wheel and drive in Accra. And trust me, some days my anxiety is still on 10,000 when I can't see where I'm going and I don't know what I'm doing. Can navigate whatever situation it is because everyone is seemingly doing what it is that they want to do. But it really isn't like that. There is a system. You just have to get in line and get with the flow. So really, the point of this video, I don't know anymore. I just wanted to eat my fruit and chit chat with you guys, is that Accra has been eye-opening. I feel like in the last year, my confidence in myself has skyrocketed so high, and I have well, myself to thank really, but also Accra. It gives you that new level of tenacity that I didn't think I had in London, and I'm grateful. I don't know what the future holds, guys. I'm still out here trying to, you know, make some coins, find myself, see if this personality is suited for, I don't know what. I don't know anymore. I really don't know anymore, but I'm bugging it out. It's gonna happen. I'm so happy I decided to do fruit today. It is hot. It is absolutely boiling and baking, and sometimes all you need is some fresh fruit. Hopefully this video hasn't been too much waffle, and even if it has, I hope it's been good waffle. And also, whilst the title says if you're moving to Accra, don't, all I'm really saying is don't make the decision unless you're very prepared. And I'm happy I made the move. I don't know what the future holds. I hope it's all good things. So I'm out. If you have enjoyed this video, if you've enjoyed eating fruit with me, don't forget to hit that like button. Also hit that subscribe. Do your girl a solid. Make my YouTube dreams come true. See you on the next mukbang. Bye bye.